In this video, we will be understanding law of diminishing marginal utility. See, law of diminishing marginal utility states that as the consumer consumes more and more units of a good, the addition to the total utility from each new unit consumed obtained goes on decreasing. Now, what does this mean? See, let us take an example of pizza. You had one pizza, you obtained a utility of let's say 200 utils. You ordered for the second pizza, like now you are consuming 2 units and you obtained the utility of 350. You ordered the third pizza, you obtained the utility of let's say 450. So your utility is increasing, that is your total utility is increasing, but it is increasing at a decreasing rate. Here from one unit you have, now you are consuming 2 units of pizza, let's say 2 pizzas, so it is your 150. The additional utility what you are getting is 150, and here you are getting is 100 utils, the additional utility. Your additional utility is decreasing, so this means the addition to the total utility from each new units consumed obtained goes on decreasing. See, this is a human being is a very rational, as you being a consumer, how many pizzas can you eat? Can you eat 10 pizzas at a time? No. I mean, like, there is something near saturation point. See, one pizza you are very hungry, it will taste good, it will give you more satisfaction. Second pizza you ordered will again fill up your stomach if you are hungry, but the satisfaction that you obtained from eating first pizza will be not equal to that, but a bit lower satisfaction from the first unit you consume. Right, so this is where your law of diminishing marginal utility holds. Let's understand and calculate the marginal utility. 4 minus 0 is 4, 7 minus 4 is 3, 9 minus 7 is 2, 10 minus 9, 1, 10 minus 10, 0, and 9 minus 10 is minus 1. So, your marginal utility you have obtained, or you can also write as the law of diminishing marginal utility states as the consumer consumes more and more units of a good, the marginal utility derived from each successive unit consumed goes on decreasing, right? So, the marginal, in the terms of marginal utility, you can also express your law of diminishing marginal utility. Or in total utility, you can also express this statement. So, the addition, what is added? 3 is added, then 7. Then 2 is added, 9. Then 1 is added. So, the addition to your total utility by consuming one additional units is decreasing, it's falling. So, this is your law of diminishing marginal utility. To every law in economics, I told you before, there are certain assumptions. So the assumption number one is consumer is rational. Number second is the same quantity of good is consumed. If you are in the first, you have taken one pizza, then you will be having the same quantity, that is 2 pizzas, not a slice in the second pizza, right? A whole with the 4 slices, let's take a standard size, 4 slices. Then again, in order to calculate the utility, you will be eating the 4 slices. So the same quantity of the good is consumed. If you are drinking 500 ml of milk at a time, so after completion of 500 milk, then again you have to take a quantity of 500 milk. So the same quantity of the good is consumed. Number third, the standard units of the commodity are consumed. Let's say you are eating one banana. So you will be eating one banana, not a half banana. So a standard unit of a commodity are consumed, like ml, then ml comparison, your kg and kg comparison, your grams and grams comparison. So this is the standard unit of a commodity are consumed. The fourth assumption is the commodity or the good is consumed on the continuous basis. Means if you want to apply the law of diminishing marginal utility, if you are eating one pizza at 11 and you have completed eating your one pizza at 11:15, that is 15 minutes you have taken to eat that one pizza, and then at 11:15 only you will start eating the second pizza. So the consumption of the commodity should be continuous. There should be no breakage or the time gap. That is, you are having one pizza at now, then you are having the second pizza after 2 hours, then after 3 hours. No, the consumption should be continuous. For the law of diminishing marginal utility, these are the two things I have explained you in the video, which were very new. Now please refer to the video of relationship between total utility and marginal utility for further concepts. So whenever you have a question of law of diminishing marginal utility in 8 marks in your CBSE board, what will you do is, you will explain the law of diminishing marginal utility. That is the first thing we have learned in this video. The second thing you will write is the assumptions, and the third thing you will do is the relationship between your total utility and marginal utility. Draw the schedule, that is your quantities, your total utility and marginal utility. Then draw the diagram and explain. So with this, you will be completing your law of diminishing marginal utility. And I have discussed this in the video of relationship between total utility and marginal utility. So you can refer the video. I hope you like the video. Do download our Scholars Learning app and enjoy the learning experience with us.